He really fit the bill, you know?
The bill?
White collar, college grad. Loves dogs, likes funny movies. 6'1", brown hair, kind eyes. Works in finance, but is outdoorsy, you know, on the weekends. I always imagined you'd have a single syllable name, like, Matt or John or Dave. In a perfect world, he drives a 4Runner, and the only thing he loves more than me is his golden lab.
Hopefully some hair on his head.
But, I mean, even that's not a deal breaker these days. A nice smile. Yeah, nice smile. My smile just might do it.
Wow, that was depressing.
Lori Gottlieb, help us here. Lori is here. She is the author of Marry Him, making the case for settling for Mr. Good Enough. Lori, look, feel my pain for a second. There are a lot of lonely men out here who are good guys. But women and this list, it's maddening. Make the argument at the center of your book, please.
Okay. You know, I'm not telling anybody to settle for somebody that they're not totally in love with or physically attracted to or anything like that. The book is based on a survey where men and women were asked if they got 80% of everything they want in their ideal mate, would they be happy with that? And women said, no, that's settling. And men said, 80%? I'd be thrilled. That's a catch. And so
80% of the women you surveyed is settling?
That's settling because, you know, the question is, what actually makes us happy in long-term romantic love? And, you know, that's the question that I explore in the book. And I'm a journalist, so I went out and I asked neurobiologists about chemistry, and I asked behavioral economists about demographics, and I asked marital researchers and divorce lawyers.
What did they say?
And, you know, the thing is, we're too picky about the things that don't matter at all for long-term romantic happiness, but we're not picky enough about the things that actually do matter.
Okay, so break that out for me. What are women... You know, it's pretty simple. It's pretty simple with men. Come on. What are women too picky about here?
Well, I'll tell you, men and women were asked what would be a deal breaker for going on a second date. And men named three things. They said she has to be cute enough. She doesn't have to look like Angelina Jolie. She just has to be cute enough. She has to be warm and kind. And she has to be interesting to talk to. Those seem like really valid criteria.
Ding, 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 ding. Pretty simple.
Right. Okay, reasonable, right? The women came back with 300 things that would rule out a guy for a second date. And we're talking about like another 2 hours and maybe a free dinner. And they wouldn't do it. And they were things like, he wore a brown belt with black shoes. Or we were having a really good time and I thought he was cute and he was interesting. But then he did this Austin Powers impression. And I just can't get that out of my mind and I can't go out with him again.
Okay, here you go.
And so, you know,
Make your other point, and then I've got another quick one for you before I lose time.
I was just going to say, Austin Powers guy could be the love of her life. If he does these impressions on the second date, okay, don't go on a third. But maybe he was just nervous. The guys who are bad first daters might be great life partners. You don't know.
Okay, let me make the other argument. You have to have a list. Lori, you have to. You just can't run around dating any Tom, Dick, or Harry. You have to develop a list.
But you have to have the right things on your list.
They have to
be the right things. You know, the character things, is he kind? Do we have the same life goals? Do we have the same values, the fundamentals? Do we enjoy each other? How do we communicate with each other? You know, somebody said to me, you know, this woman that I was really interested in wouldn't go out with me because I didn't read the same books that she did. But
yeah,
She's madly in love with this guy who reads the same books, but he doesn't call her when he says he will.
All right, here we go. Very quickly, we asked folks to send in some thoughts. At our blog, Kim writes, I have found my Mr. close enough. I realized that I wasn't going to find a perfect man, so consider whether my mate's positives outweighed, I'm trying to go as fast as I can, outweighed his negatives, which they do. Julia says, kind, caring, and crazy in love with me. I think that is not too much to ask. And Jackie, hey, Tony, I'm 55 years old, and I live on the coast in Washington State. Our area is quite depressed, so it is hard to find a guy that matches my qualifications. I am looking for a guy who has teeth, a car, and a job. Lori, got to go. Thanks for your time. Happy Valentine's Day.
Thank you so much.